In July of 2010, Josh Hill just came off a breakout SX season. At 20 years of age, he was tied for the 450 Supercross crown when the series moved east for round 8 of the championship. After showing much promise his rookie year in 2008, becoming rookie of the year, getting 5th in the series, 3 second place finishes, and a win in Minneapolis. The following year, his career seemed to get sidetracked by a string of small injuries and a taste of the party life. But in 2010, Josh got the opportunity to ride for the San Manuel Yamaha team alongside Jane Stewart for zero salary, a SX-only contract, and took full advantage. With the whole summer off to do as he pleased, Josh wanted to continue to compete and was invited to the Summer X Games for the SX and Speed and Style events. So training twice a day started. SX practice with his team in the mornings and FMX practice in the evenings. Being coached by FMX stars Robbie Madison and Nate Adams, Josh set out to learn the backflip. He successfully landed an 80-foot backflip to dirt, but on a repeat attempt, things went wrong. He bailed off from under rotating, shattering his right femur, pelvis, and humerus. But that was just the beginning. After numerous operations, Josh developed compartment syndrome in his opposite leg, leaving him paralyzed from the kneecap down. Doctors didn't leave much hope for a full recovery. After spending 18 days in the hospital, he was sent home by ambulance and began home physical therapy. Being taken out in the prime of his career wasn't an easy pill to swallow. He began to seek the help of doctors and therapists that would give him a glimpse of hope at being able to walk again. After 4 months of intense physical therapy, Josh was out of his wheelchair. And in late October, still with no feeling from his mid-leg down, Josh stuffed his foot in a boot and started riding again. Not well, but he was riding again. Something thought unimaginable by most of the doctors who he had seen. Shortly after, Josh got the opportunity that may have been his saving grace. The Dodge H&H team believed in his drive to get back to racing and signed him to a 2-year deal to rehabilitate and get back to competition. Josh moved to Oregon and surrounded himself with his family and began to prepare for the Washougal Outdoor National. In July, he returned again, exactly 2 years to the day from his almost fatal injury, and was able to finish both motos and walk away with 22nd overall. A huge accomplishment, but not the type of result to ensure Josh a spot on a factory team the following year. But much to the surprise of the entire MX industry, the newly restructured RCH Dodge Saquon Suzuki team stuck behind Hill and re-signed him for the 2013 Supercross Series.
Yeah, now that I'm back racing and I'm back doing what I love and actually being in the mix, my goals are just gonna keep raising. I think I really think I can get back up to the level that I started, you know, or that I was in 2008 and 2010 and challenging for race wins. I mean, I've said it over and over again, it's not gonna happen overnight, but it's definitely seeming more and more feasible, and just gotta keep my nose to the grindstone and just keep doing what I love and riding dirt bikes.